Hey everyone, let's dive into one of Google Sheet's most powerful functions, XLOOKUP. Whether you're a beginner or an advanced user, this function can revolutionize how you work with data. Stick around and we'll explore how to use XLOOKUP and walk through some practical examples. XLOOKUP is a versatile function that allows you to search for a value in a range or an array and return a corresponding value from the same position in another range or array. It's like VLOOKUP or HLOOKUP on steroids, offering advanced features and flexibility. Let's begin by breaking down how XLOOKUP works. The syntax is straightforward. I've broken it down here, and let's quickly run through what each argument does. Search key is a value you want to search for. This could be a string, a number, etc. The lookup range is a range or array to search for a lookup value within. The result range is a range or array containing the values to return. Our remaining arguments are all optional, as denoted by the square brackets. Missing value gives us an option to return a value if there is no match for our lookup value. Match mode can be used to determine the match type, for example, whether you want an exact match or an approximate match. Lastly, the search mode controls the search direction, whether you wish to go from first to last, and a few other things. Let's now begin working through some practical examples using the XLOOKUP function so you can get a better understanding of how powerful it is. As you can see here, we have a list of employees at some company. We want to be able to enter the name of an employee in the cell B3 here and retrieve that salary in the cell C3. Let's put John in our employee cell. Now we can call our XLOOKUP function. As we talked about previously, the first argument is the search key, and this is going to be John. So let's just select the cell that contains John. Then we need to find our lookup range, which is simply the array of cells that we want to search for John in. This is going to be our employee column. Then, adding another comma, we move to our next argument, which is the result range. So, this will be our salaries column. Hitting enter, you can see that we are presented with John's salary as expected. In changing our employee's name here, you can see that we can update our salary accordingly. XLOOKUP will also allow us to handle errors as well. Let's say that we are looking for an employee that doesn't exist within our list. All we need to do is add another comma and enter some text that says employee cannot be found. Now, let's enter a name that doesn't exist within our employee list, such as Martin. And as you can see, we are returned employee not found. We can also use different match modes. Let's say that we wish to look up an employee that makes $75,000 a year salary. We call our XLOOKUP function, and we want to look up the 75,000 and return our first instance of this exact salary. As you can see, when we get to our match mode argument, we have several options that we can select. In this instance, we want exactly 75,000. So let's type 0. Hitting enter, you can see that we get returned John. However, if we change our search parameter to 74,500, we get an error. But if we change our match mode to exactly match or a larger value, then we can get close to that salary and it'll return John. Another cool thing we can do is return multiple values for a given search term. So I'll quickly add a few more categories for all our employees. Now, at the top here, let's repeat our titles and adjust our return array to include our employee's position and ID. Hitting enter, these pieces of data will spill into our adjacent cells like so. Now, by changing our employee's name, we can easily call all of our employee's information. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to use the XLOOKUP function in Google Sheets. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.